Welcome back, intrepid heroes, maniacal villains, and my fellow Americans. It's been a trying time since our election in November, and this week was President's Day. Well, we all know how we're dealing with that in different capacities throughout the country. Now, of course, no presidency is without fault. And frankly, it's tough to be on the press all the time. We've done a lot of digging over here at the Brothers Magic Channel. We're just doing what we can to just try to be supportive of Americans, be fair and balanced to everyone out there. We've done extensive reading out there. We've taken an introductory to law courses. We got to know our rights with Reader's Digest. And the last great American journalist that actually had the hearts and minds of the people, we've brushed up on Jon Stewart as well. It's a classic now. They're teaching this in public universities now. Amazing. So, in spirit of democracy and in spirit of keeping up with not only current times, but taking a time to look back at our present, past, and inevitable future, I've decided to do some digging. And what I discovered left me almost speechless. It turns out that way before the advent of, you know, color TV and Twitter and all these amazing other outlets to give us a little glimpse into the presidency of the United States, it turns out alternative facts have been happening all along. You know, it's not up for debate anymore. Alternative facts are a thing. And so going through the halls of the Library of Congress and going through the archives on the .org sites and so many different media outlets, I was able to do up some research. And now, for your thoughts and consideration, I present you now with alternative facts for every single president that ever held the position. George Washington never actually had wooden teeth. Instead, he took the teeth from his enemies, right out of their still living, breathing faces. Amazing.
John Adams passed the Aliens and Seditions Act to make sure that no other sitting president could be abducted by extraterrestrial life.
Thomas Jefferson, he sent Lewis and Clark out west not to find a faster route to the Pacific, but to find each other.
James Madison got really jealous when his wife, Dolly, saved George Washington's portrait over his own.
James Monroe, you really just kind of wanted to retire in Florida. That's it.
John Quincy Adams was actually just a time-traveling reincarnation of his father, John Adams. Andrew Jackson figured this out, and to save not only the United States of America, but all of space and time itself, he was forced to behead the president.
Andrew Jackson has never even been to New Orleans.
Martin Van Buren assumed his alias Martin Van Ruin when he challenged and successfully beat Andrew Jackson in one-on-one combat for a heavyweight champion of the world.
William H. Harrison. Alright, I'm gonna break the fourth wall at this point. Guys, Harrison didn't do anything. He died a month into office. The guy got pneumonia from his inaugural address. There is no alternative facts. Nothing else happened to the son of a bitch.
John Tyler. Really? Just kind of like tipping over canoes.
James K. Polk would manifest destiny every night in his pants.
Zachary Taylor. Even this guy didn't vote for himself. What?
Millard Fillmore. He's the beloved and favorite son of Buffalo, New York. He's so beloved that to this day, there's even still an all-you-can-eat spicy wing challenge named after him today. You guessed it. It's called the Fillmore.
And finally, we'll conclude this session with Franklin Pierce, who went down in history as an alcoholic, but really, it was all a clever ruse. The man never touched a drop in his life.
Thank you so much for joining us on this special Alternative Facts episode about the United States presidents. If you like what you saw, be sure to hit that like and subscribe button, share it with those that care about history, about alternative facts, and about supporting the most reserved and highest office in the land. Now be sure to do your civil duty, and if you're in the Metro Detroit or Ann Arbor areas in Michigan, come check out our show at Barefoot Productions on March 4th. It's a live one night of entertainment, improv theater made up completely right on the spot. So come on by. Tickets and info are in the description below. Stay strong.